What began as an experiment to bring my 11-year-old daughter into my business has evolved into Our Young Creators, a podcast, a training center, and a movement dedicated to equipping kids with real-world marketable skills so that they can fund their own brighter futures. We're here to inspire you to turn consumption time on devices into creation time and use technology as a tool to bond and not bicker with your kids. Join us each week as we share the inner workings of our partnership and bring you stories from guests of all ages and from all walks of life on our quest to nurture and to celebrate our young creators. Good morning, everyone. I am so excited you're joining me today for this very interesting topic. Today, we're chatting all about what is your minimum viable effort. Before we get there, if this is your first time tuning in and we haven't had the privilege of meeting yet, my name is Yang Pratt, and I am the Chief Dreamer, podcaster, and author right here at Our Young Creators. And here at OYC, we are passionate about equipping kids with real-world skills so that they can go out there, create a life of their dreams by serving others and getting compensated to do so. Welcome, welcome. Hello, Renee. Hello, Angie. I'm so glad to see you here. So I wanted to share with you a little bit about what I've been doing for the past couple of weeks, because I think it might put some perspective, especially into summer, and how much you are actually working in your business. Renee, I love what you do too, and I'm so glad that you're here today. So over the past couple of weeks, we have been doing a lot of traveling. We had a couple trips that were planned, and the timing of them put them kind of back to back. So over a three-week span, I think we were home, you know, 3 or 4 days, enough to do laundry and to catch up, repack, hop back in the car, and go again. And my husband came home last night and surprised me and said, hey, guess what? I'm off tomorrow so we can go on another adventure. And while I'm super grateful to go on those adventures, there's just lots going on. And that really sort of leads me to today's topic about effort. Now, I have been experimenting with how much effort I have been putting into my business on a daily basis. Mostly because I've not been around. I've been traveling and I never know if the Wi-Fi connection is going to work, if the 4G connection is going to work, or if we're going to have any cell service at all. So I had to do a little bit of strategy before I left and do some work up front and then schedule things out. And now it's kind of a cool place to be because I'm realizing that in order to maintain my business, still grow it, and still connect with all of you out there, I'm not needing to be on here 24/7. I'm not needing to post repeatedly here on Facebook or on Instagram. I've discovered that if I can be strategic and schedule things out and show up when it's convenient for me and our schedule and our summer travel adventures, it's really been working. So as we're gearing up for back to school, just about around here, we have about another month or so before school starts. it makes me stop and think. Usually, when the girls are away at school, I work the whole day. I love what I do. I love connecting with you. I love helping people share their messages. I love helping families create stronger bonds using technology and the devices we all love. But I had to really think about what I'm going to do when they go back to school because I've discovered that I don't need to be working 6 or 8 or 10 hours a day every single day to keep my business going. So my question for you is, do you know what your minimum viable effort is? Do you know how many hours per day or per week that you absolutely need to put into your business in order to help it grow and get to that next level? Or is that something you still need to figure out? Let me know in the comments what you figured out about your minimum viable effort. Now, when I was thinking about sharing this topic with you, I almost didn't because when I talk about minimum viable effort, on the one hand, it sounds kind of like I'm saying we should all be lazy and not do the things that we know we need to do to grow our businesses. And I really hemmed and hawed thinking, I don't know if this is the topic that I want to talk about because it just makes me sound like I'm not putting in effort into my business. And that is definitely not the case. I've just discovered that I can be working far less and getting the exact same result in my business. So why on earth am I plugging away all day long when I don't need to be? So my challenge for you today is to really start to keep track of the things that you are doing during your day. And maybe you do it for 3 days, 5 days, even a week. And just for each time block, write down what it is that you are doing to see if there are any patterns that arise. Once you have this all taken care of, you can go through and see if there are recurring patterns, recurring themes. Are you working on graphics, perhaps inside of Canva, 3 or 4 times a week? Is there a way you can put that together once a week or once every other week in order to get that work batched and done so you're only having to touch it once? Or maybe you have a podcast or a blog and it's something you do regularly, maybe once a week or twice a week. Is there a way that you can block those and batch those together? Now, I have a huge backlog right now of podcast episodes, and I love that because I can schedule them in advance, super far out into the future, so that if plans change and we have an impromptu road trip like today, then I know that everything for the week or the next 2 weeks at least is done. And one thing that I've been doing lately, which has really been super, super helpful, is that for our daily flash briefing on Amazon Alexa, and if you're not sure what the heck Alexa is, who she is, what she does, go back and watch yesterday's video because I dive into detail about Alexa, what she does, who she is, and how she can help you inside of your business. What I love to do with Alexa, though, because they're only super short episodes, usually 2 to 3 minutes, I will spend an hour, maybe an hour and a half, depending on the day and how many episodes I want to record, and I will sit down and just record them in one session. And that's it. They're super, super easy. They're done. From there, I can just upload them, schedule them, and I can be thinking about what I want to do next. And I just love this idea of batching content. And this has really, really, really helped me to put in less effort on a daily basis because I'm carving out the time upfront and very strategically and actually putting it on my calendar. So I use Google Calendar and I put notifications in there. So I block out times on Mondays, like I said, for recording my Alexa flash briefings. And about 30 minutes before that happens, I have a notification that pops up on my phone and on my computer telling me what is next, because the worst thing to do when you wake up in the morning is to decide what to do, right? It's like trying to decide what to wear every day. Sometimes there's just too many choices, and sometimes you just stay in your PJs all day. And I've discovered the same thing about scheduling and getting work done in advance. If you can block out the time, get it done, you put systems in place to remind you to do that. So I know every Monday at 8:30 a.m. I'm going to be recording my Alexas. I just start to realize that that's my schedule. That's my new routine. And any routine, of course, is a habit. And it's going to feel strange at first. And there are definitely some days when I don't feel like doing that particular thing. So what I sometimes do is that I will have a couple of time blocks throughout the week and I can interchange them. So if on Mondays I'm not feeling the vibe or the feeling the energy or emotion about recording 10 or 12 Alexa flash briefings, I might just go work on that new opt-in or something in a different time block and interchange those. So everything still happens during the day, during the week. Usually it happens the day that I've scheduled it. However, you know, life happens, things pop up that we don't expect. So if we can just plan to succeed and plan our success by time blocking, by taking an evaluation of what actually needs to get done during the day, during the week, the month, the quarter, however you plan it, and really just reverse engineer that. Once you have your list of things that you do during the week, you can, after you've time batched them or time blocked them, the next thing you can do is start to delegate some of those tasks. And for me right now, I delegate a lot of tasks to my kids. They're both interested in helping me and being able to pay for their own adventures, which I definitely enjoy and appreciate. And it makes me definitely one proud mama. So there, of course, is some training time, some mentoring time with each of them individually to do those things. However, by being able to delegate and knowing that they can do certain tasks and they're doing high-level tasks for me that need to get done and move our business forward, even if I can't get to them, I know they can do them. And that's the beauty of delegation. And if you're looking for someone to offload things onto, let me know, because my girls now love helping other people, like Renee, who is on this video. They love helping other people because it excites them. They get to use the skills they have, which most of their friends don't have. You know, they have these fun ninja skills, and for them to be able to go out there and serve others and to demonstrate to them that by serving others, that's our purpose here on this planet, right? We're here to share our gifts, and we do that by serving others. And I just love that. And then the third thing you'll want to do as you look at your schedule is to start deleting things. Yep, I said delete. I know, and that sounds so scary because as we're so, so busy every single day, it's hard to imagine not doing something. However, the more you can delete the extraneous things, those things that are just filling time, they keep you busy, but they're not moving your business forward. Here's an example. So as I'm posting on social media, it's super easy to get totally sucked in and see the beautiful adventures that you're having, Angie, or that you're having, Renee, flying that drone. It's super easy for me to do that and then spend a huge amount of time in social media being reactive and not doing anything that is moving me forward. So literally, I have to set a timer. I have to, you know, set a very short amount of time. So 30 minutes is what I get. Or every other week, I am scheduling and posting and interacting. Whatever it works for you, take a look at that particular area, because I know that's a personal struggle, because it's fun to see what everyone else is doing. But while I'm busy watching what they're doing, I'm definitely not doing anything that is moving my business forward. So really start to look at the time blocks that you've scheduled, that you wrote out for a day or a couple days or a week, and then figure out those things that you can just delete completely off your list. Now, I want to know, is there one thing you know right now that you want to absolutely delete off your schedule because it's not driving you forward in your business? It's not helping you to build relationships or connections? Let me know in the comments what that is, because I'm always curious to know how other people experience and overcome these same challenges, especially when it comes to being on social media and, you know, other fun things we get to do. Well, my friends, that is what I wanted to share today about minimum viable effort. Let me know how this experiment goes for you. Once you've written down everything you do during the day and figured out what you can chunk together, so you're going to do those things to move your business forward, what things can you delegate, and what things you can delete? Because again, I'm always looking for better ways to be more productive during the day and really to work more efficiently and work more effectively so that I can put in less direct effort, but still get back the return that I am hoping to get. Okay, my friends, we are off for another grand adventure. I'll be posting some pictures and things over on Instagram stories. So be sure that we're connected over there so you can see what we are up to this weekend. Okay, my friends, I'll be back again for sure next Tuesday at 11 a.m. Pacific. Cheers, my friends.
If you're ready to harness the power of technology and get your message out into the world in a big way to make the impact you know you were meant to make for yourself, for your business, or with your family, head over to Instagram or Facebook and message me at Our Young Creators and let me know that you're ready to be our next graduate in the upcoming Podcast in a Weekend class.